kicker. That's Cameron Dicker, set to get us started.
And off we go from M&T Bank Stadium.
Devin Duvernay now returning from the end zone.
And he's going to be out of bounds on the return. Not a great return. They'll start back around the 17.
They're on 17-yard line.
Jackson, first play, going to throw.
Rolling to his right.
That's complete with Zay Flowers with it.
And marking down way up close to the 40 at the 39. On first and 10, it's Jackson. Escaping the pressure right.
And Jackson going to have the first down as he will get to the ground to avoid the contact.
Throwing now, Jackson on first down, eluding the pressure right.
Yet again, targeting and fighting Mark Andrews.
And out of bounds all the way down at the 3. They go right back to him for 20 and a first.
A lot of precision being shown on this opening drive. They've been methodical, they've been crisp, and as a reward, they're going to be set up with an early first and goal.
A terrific opening drive has them knocking on the door, first and goal. Quick strikeout wide by Jackson. Touchdown!
And now Beckham from 3 yards out.
And the Ravens put the Knights' first points on the board as they take the early lead.
Justin Tucker for the extra point. And the Ravens lead it 7-0. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. Oh, a good-looking return set up here. And great field position coming up as he gets this just shy of the 45, out of bounds at the 44.
Well, he gave up the first touchdown of the game, but how about the response? Big-time return. Now it's their chance to try and put points on the board.
Chargers in good field position to start out. First and 10 at their own 44. Here's Herbert. It's caught inside the 25. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. Herbert operating from the red zone. And it's intercepted at the goal line.
Kyle Hamilton picks it. And the Ravens force the turnover. They'll take over at the 10.
The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive.
They've got the 7-0 lead. Now they've got the football back after their defense got the stop, CD. And you get the feeling if they could score here, they really have all the momentum on their side.
And you just wonder right now, as the quarterback and the play caller totally in sync, are they of one mind that, hey, we worked last time, let's keep doing it until they stop us? Or do they go to a different section in the playbook, show them something different? Either way, they want a repeat of their first drive.
And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8, 2nd and 2.
Just about every quarterback is trained to really look downfield first before you come back and make a nice safe throw. And
And in this case, that's exactly what he did. Found his running back, let him create some space, and it turned out to be a nice play for the offense.
Jackson. Defensively, celebration time because they finally forced an incompletion. He was perfect throwing the ball to that point.
Yeah, but from his viewpoint, they didn't force the incompletion. He just missed. That's how hot he is right now. That's how he wants to continue to throw the ball.
And he will have the Ravens first down by about a yard as they're able to convert on third and two. Play action with Jackson. He's got his man downfield. That's Bateman. And he takes this one down almost all the way to the 30. After one, 7-0. From the 32 now, here's first and 10. Jackson. That's caught. It's Flowers. And he'll go out of bounds inside the 15-yard line. Another big gainer that time. This one goes for 19 yards. And defensively, they were in zone coverage there. Do you have to be a little careful you're losing playing against a good quarterback like he is to not play too much zone?
Yeah, you have to be careful about how much time you're giving up. I think it's a good point you just brought up. So maybe if you still want to play zone, you go to a zone blitz scheme, and you can drop anyone out of your defensive front, defensive end, defensive tackle. It doesn't matter. You just exchange someone.
And oh, it'll be intercepted. Picked off by Michael Davis. And the Chargers are going to take possession here. It's a touchback, and they'll take over at the 20-yard line. The Charger drive about to get going. In a close game like this, Charles, those interceptions like they had on the last drive could be costly, but here they've got another opportunity to seize control of this game.
And they better take advantage of it, because otherwise, if they end up losing by one score, they'll relive this over and over and over until they have another opportunity to wipe it away.
Operating from the 27 now. Here's second and three. Now Herbert with it, looking to pass. And the Raven pressure too much. Down he goes. Yes, third and 10. Back to throw here, Herbert. And that's going to be incomplete. The contact there with the Jordan at that free. Up front down. No move to get Herbert off the field. They're going for this. They snap it to Herbert. And Allen's got it. Oh, it breaks a tackle, and he's got an alley. And he'll be out of bounds right at the 40. A curious decision to go for it, but it pays off with a first down.
I don't know if I agree with that. I guess they don't care if I agree with that. But, boy, you have to be surprised by that, right?
I definitely was surprised that they decided to go for it in this situation. But they must have either felt like they either had a great play call on, or they're trying to show extreme confidence.
In on the stop, the former Georgia Bulldog, Roquan Smith. Here's second and 10. Now it's Herbert. And that's going to be too high. Out of bounds and incomplete.
Not only did he have a chance to scan the field there, it felt like he had a chance to scan it twice. The protection was that good. Unfortunately for him, the coverage downfield, equally good.
That's caught by his tight end, Gerald Everett. And he'll only get this to the 47. He needed a few more yards to pick up the first. Here we go on fourth, Herbert. And he is caught. And he takes this one down almost all the way to the the 30. 21 yards there. A big play on fourth down. So after the big play on fourth, here's first and 10. Out of the gun, Herbert. Finds the open man. It's Mike Williams. And he will have a first down here as they get into field goal range, down just shy of the 20. Herbert will give this one to Eckler. And he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down. Herbert now. And he'll slide to a halt here. Still a little shy of the first down marker. Now a timeout taken. Perhaps a chance for one more quick play and then another timeout if they hurry. We'll see. Johnston sent in motion. They'll send a receiver here in motion right. Herbert wants to throw it on third and one. Looking in zone, but it's incomplete.
He did a fine job there, not hitting it before the ball arrived. And I've got to tell you, you can often mistime that play because of the angles of approach. When you're going to get him, sometimes you panic as well and think, I've got to be there right now. Instead, in this case, timed it perfectly and knocked it free.
So we've reached intermission here in a low-scoring game. 7-3 is our score. As we'll get you down the coast to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman at REA Sports Halftime Report. Coach! And we welcome you back now. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon, getting set for quarter number three here. The Chargers going to get the football first here in this second half, and they trail as we get back underway. And the fair catch signaled for and taken, so they'll begin this third quarter from their 25-yard line. The Charger drive about to get going. Charles, it'll be interesting to see what adjustments this offense made in the locker room. Haven't really been able to get anything going offensively. Virtually nothing in the ground attack. He's got a man complete. Now he's loose down the left sideline. Touchdown, LA. Keenan Allen, 75 yards. And the Chargers come right out of the locker room and score here in the opening minute of the third quarter. Extra point up and good by Dicker. And the lead is now 10-7. So after the touchdown, here's Dicker out to kick this one off. And he'll get it up past the 20 to about the 22. Jackson and the Ravens come up now first and 10 at their own 22. They'll try and start this drive in the air. Flush to his right. And this is into the hands of Andrews downfield. And he's going to be ridden out of bounds down inside the 25. It's a big play there for Baltimore. 57 yards.
And this is one of the toughest parts about being a defensive back. When a play breaks down like this, you're taught to plaster to a receiver. Find the nearest one and adhere yourself to it. But you can only stay with the receiver so long if the play continues to develop. He knows where he's going. You do not.
Now Jackson on first down. That is caught, Rashawn Bateman. And they've got it inside the 10 at the 8. Looking to speed things up here, going with some tempo. Now Lamar changing the play. Play action. It's Jackson. And that'll be taken in by Andrews for a Ravens touchdown. 8 yards on the touchdown pass. And the Ravens have retaken a third quarter lead. Tucker able to connect on the extra point. And the lead is now 14-10. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown.
And he'll elect not to run with it. And a fair catch on the kickoff will move the ball to the 25.
The Charger drive about to get going.
Well, partner, you know, coaches always say that every play is designed to score a touchdown. Sometimes that's not really true, but last drive, that was the case. One play to get into the end zone, and now they'll try to duplicate that success here.
And it's rare for those moments to happen. Incredible when they do. And you saw the celebration. Pure, unbridled joy after that one.
So the big play moves them all the way across midfield. It's first and 10 from the 45. This is caught inside the 15. And he'll go out of bounds inside the 15-yard line.
Another big play here as they strike for 31.
So how about this for field position after the big play? Inside the 15 now as they come up on first and 10. Herbert. Got a man, it's Allen for the Charger touchdown. Keenan Allen with now his second touchdown of this third quarter.
And the Chargers have taken the lead here this third quarter.
Extra point up and good by Dicker. And it's now 17-14.
Here's Dicker now as he'll send this one away.
I already got it started. That's the crazy part, bro. I just fucking fat fingered a post when I was wide open. So your defense is horrible. Sorry, bro. That shit is not it. I'm gonna keep it a B. He threw that, bro. Like, what the fuck, bro? This nigga just throwing shit. Baylor Tiger. He's going to that post route, too. I know you were going to that post route. That shit was not open. Shit open, bro. Niggas done, bro. Yeah, you better slide. I'll take that nigga life away.